All right, you have an understanding of what aperture is. Now let's talk about shutter speed. Shutter speed means how long the film sensor is exposed to light. So if, let me try to give you an example. You're in a dark room. Say you're in a closet where no light is at. Say the closet box is the camera. To help you understand what shutter speed is, say you have a 1,000-watt light bulb outside of that door. So when the door is closed, no light is getting in. What shutter speed is basically you opening the door and allowing light to get inside the closet. Now, as far as that's shutter. Now, as far as shutter speed, is going to be how fast you open and close the door. So, say for instance, if you're looking for a pen, a little bitty needle. Well, if you open the door, like open shut, that's not going to give you enough time to find a pen. So that's going to be what's considered fast shutter speed. Now, slow shutter speed is when you open the door, allow light to get in, and then you hurry up and look for your pen before the door closes back up. Boom. So that gives you enough time to find a pen. So even though pen have nothing to do with what I'm talking about right now, I'm just helping you to grasp what shutter speed is, even though you probably know. Some of you don't, some of you don't. But that helps you to grasp what shutter speed is and what it does. It allows light inside the room or inside the camera at a specific amount of time. All right. So now what happens, and say the closet is considered the sensor of the camera. So you want light, you adjust your shutter speed based on the amount of light and how long that amount of light is going to click on your sensor. Now, as a rule, the slower your shutter speed, the more blurry the objects is going to be. All right. So if you open it, the shutter speed open, and then you close it, then you'll notice that, you know, you see the baby jumping in the air. He is blurry. And the faster your shutter speed, as a rule of thumb, the image is going to be sharper. So you see the kids, they jumping up. You can actually see the little lines in their hair, and it's not blurry. So that's what all of that is all about. When you jump in the air, you know, a lot of times when people is doing photography or video, they will use a faster shutter speed on kids because kids is mobile. They always move around. They're jumping all over the place. You see, I got two pictures of kids. They just jumping all. They like jumping beans. They move too much, man. It's too much. But anyway, if you want to capture that action, you will speed up your shutter speed. If you really don't, you know, too much care about that action, then you'll slow your shutter speed down. Now, shutter speed has a lot to do with the amount of light and the type of exposure that you want. Now, let me show you some other things real quick before we move on to ISO and how all of this tie in together. We'll click another image here, and you see this is at a high shutter speed. I wrote it down. This is a shutter speed of 1 over 2500. You see? So if you can look, you can see the detail in his little lines of hair right there. I mean, that should be blurry. But the shutter is opening so fast that it's able to capture all these little intricate details. It's almost like it's 3D or like the Matrix, frozen in time. Here's another image at a shutter speed of 1 over 2500. Look at this bird. Look at the sharp detail. And as another rule, fam, the higher the shutter speed for any image, the higher quality the image is going to be, the sharper the image is going to be. So, for example, if we're shooting a video, the higher shutter speed we use when we're shooting a video, the sharper the image is going to be. Now, generally, we usually use a 1 over 60 shutter speed so that we can get that film look. But a lot of people kind of adjust the shutter speed based on what they want in particular. For example, a fighting scene or a war scene. You ever watch them war movies where they shooting and everything kind of look like it's flickering, or, you know, those modern war movies where you know, they shooting and they screaming and dust and particles is blowing in the air, but for some reason it's not blurry. It's really in detail. Let me pause this and I'm sure I can pull one up for a second. I'm going to show you the creative use of using shutter speed, because generally we would use a shutter speed of 1 over 60 or 1 over 50, and that gives us the basic film look. But sometimes people use it in a creative way. Now let me show you the creative way that they would use this. Let me pause this and pull up an image real quick. Okay, guys, this is all I could find, but this is suffice. What I was talking about, and actually I was looking for something else, but this is good enough here. We can't see the detail, but what we can see is you notice the debris. Now, normally, you know, cameras not normally capture this debris. This is able to be captured because of the wide depth of field. You know what? I know I'm confusing you guys. Not the shallow depth of field, but the wide depth of field. I know it sounds crazy. Let me show you what I'm talking about when I say wide depth of field. They're right here. That's wide depth of field. That's shallow depth of field, even though it's open. It don't make sense to do it. But don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I'll just kind of use the term a little bit more simpler. Let me just say the smaller the hole of the aperture, the smaller the hole or the higher the f-stop, you're able to pick up these little, you see these little dots? These little bitty dots is in focus, sharp focus. Now, if we was actually watching this particular sequence, it would look like a staccato. It would look like when you go to the club and they got the staccato flash lights going, and it looked like you ticking. If you dance and it just looked like you like that, 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 that. Well, that's a fast shutter speed. So when you see the action, it give a more intense look. So those are the special reasons how they use it. That's like the special effects way that they use faster shutter speeds. And the same thing with here. You see the debris is sharp. You don't see no blurriness. Only time you see a blurry object is when it's really moving really, really fast. You see what I'm saying? Really fast. But other than that, the shutter speed here is probably, I don't know, maybe 5,000, you know, I don't know how high they use in film, but it's really, you really get a sharp image here. You know, everything is, you can freeze it in time and see the detail. So that's what that's all about when you're using a faster shutter speed. So now faster shutter speed, again, it allows, less light in, or should I say, not less light in, because it's about the aperture, but it's how long the light hit the lens. You see what I'm saying? It's how long the light hit the lens. Now, if you can understand, I'm going to pull up some other pics real quick. If that can help, here's another one. Here's good. You see the little bitty tricklets of water? It's like frozen in time. It's frozen in time. See his hair? You can see the little bitty line. Ain't no way in the world you can get that shooting with a normal shutter speed of, you know, like 160 or, you know, 125. You can't get it. It's going to be blurry. And here's another one. This is another good image. Actually, it looked really better than that. Here's another really good image. You see the little driplets. And basically, you know, I can just go on and on. The same thing, you know, this is somebody catching a bird. You see the wings is a little blurry. So obviously, he was flapping in the air. And you know how fast these birds are, real fast. Here's another one. You know, little bitty, small, little driplets look like bubbles. That looks awesome. But, I'm sorry. I'm losing my point. So the shutter speed, so the slower the shutter speed, it allows more light in. Why? Because you're opening the door longer. So by opening the door longer, you allow more light, so you're able to shoot in lower lighting situations. So T, how does this, you know, how do understanding the aperture and the shutter speed help me to, compose, or should I say, have the best exposure? Well, we're going to talk about one thing. We're going to move on to the next module. We're going to talk about one last thing, and that's the ISO. And by understanding this a little bit, you'll kind of have a more of understanding the type of lens you should buy and why. Like if you're as a wedding wedding shooter? You like, you know, or you shoot a lot of video in clubs, or you shoot a lot of pictures and videos in wedding, then you want to get you want to look into getting the type of camera that have a really low f-stop, you know, like a 1.2 or 1.4 or 1.8. Why? Because it opens up wide, it allows more light in, and then the lower the shutter speed, the more you add an even more light in. You understand where I'm coming from? But it's a balancing act. It's just a balancing act, and that's what we're going to talk about, the ISO. But one more thing I want to say before I close this module is there is a warning. When shooting in very slow shutter speed, use a tripod. You want to use a tripod when you're using a slower shutter speed because there's so much light coming in that if you move the camera, I'm talking about even a hair, you can get blur. You can get massive amount of blur. So you want to use a tripod when you're using the lower shutter speed. Remember that. Remember that. Now, if you're using the higher shutter speed, remember, it's going so fast that it's not going to get no blur. Remember, we saw those sharp images. You see, you can imagine how fast the bird is flying. The wings is all in focus. Same thing here with that. You know they're moving fast, but everything is crispy. But the slower shutter speed, you know, actually, I don't have any pictures, but let me show you a picture of what happens when you use an extremely slow shutter speed. Okay, here's some examples on when you use slow shutter speed. And actually, I pulled a few of these off the internet here. That's already kind of give you a comparison. But you see here, this is at 1/200th of a second, and you see how crispy and clear it is. It's like it's frozen in time, like 3D or like Matrix. And then you see this is a slower shutter speed, and you see we have the blur. Same thing with this here. Look like he's hanging on a wall on the strings, and he probably used a really high, maybe a 200 or 500 or 1,000, 1/2 of a 1,000 shutter speed, where this one right here, he may have used a 115, you know, a 125, something slower, maybe a 150. And here, this is extremely slow. This is so slow that you don't even see the cars. You're only picking up the lights. That's how slow the shutter speed is. And these are creative ways that people is using shutter speed. Now, this right here, this is people drawing. This is another creative way that they use slow shutter speed. And they're taking lights or mirrors or whatever, whatever light source they use, and they're actually drawing pictures with lights. And that's how you get that, because the door is opening and closing so slow that there is able to capture all of this light all in one instance. But you got to have that sucker locked down on a tripod so gangster style, I don't even know what to tell you. And then here's another one here of a chicken. He's trying to get away, a hen. He's trying to get away from me because I'm hungry. I want some fried Popeyes or some Church's chicken. Anyway, those are little examples of you know, the difference between the fast shutter speed, which would be something like this, or something like this, and then the slow shutter speed of something like that, or that. So now that we understand what shutter speed is and how we can benefit from that, let's talk about the last thing, and that's ISO.